Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield Blind. I'm Amethyst Luatari. That's my friend. And we gotta go back to where we came from. The interesting thing, well, knock on wood, that everything goes right with this recording. Alright, so how do I do this? I'll explain something in a second. No. How about not? How do I move over there again? Oh, I got up. Nope, I hit control. I have an exposure pack. I didn't know that. Let's try to remember. Oh, that's right. I've been using WASD, I think. No, I have not. I have not been using that. So I need to switch over. Ah, there we go. I need to take away from something else, don't I? Is that good? One thing of grav? Okay, we'll try it like that. Okay. Have to remember the keys. I don't change those very often. Time to wrap up things with Rokov, then head to New Atlantis and the GalBank archives, because we have Larry Dumbroski GalBank credentials. Rokov. How do I wrap things up with Rokov? Well, I don't know. Here it just says we're proceeding to New Atlantis. That is all. Oh, really? I thought I had to jump all the way back. Oh, only the first time, right? Because now I fast traveled?
Did you know I used to have an office near the top of Mast? How far the mighty have fallen, eh?
Yeah, now you're down on the sidewalk, right? I'm going. Where am I going? This way. So I have a bad disc. Well, maybe it's I had a bad disc. They had bad sectors. For those who don't know, it's just all or most of you, because I've only mentioned it, I think, twice. I had set myself up with a. Well, there's GalBank. That's where we're going. Except, I'd have to swim. She's really taken off. Like a human rocket. She is. So yeah, bad sectors on disk. Right, so for those who don't know, I'm using a dual boot system because I have Windows 7 and Windows 10. Windows 7 is way back from when I got this computer in 2012. And the Windows 10 I got in like April or May.
Can you imagine how many credits flow through this place?
Last year.
Figuratively, of course.
I'm trying to talk to the peoples. So my Windows 10 disk had errors for some reason. I don't know why. First, it wouldn't be recognized by the system at all. I could not boot with it. It was not present in the BIOS. Because that's how I choose which one I'm going to start up. Windows 7, they said, it's really good for a lot of older emulators and games tend to run better on 7. I'm sure all the stuff I'm running now could also be run on Windows 10, because right now I'm only playing Starfield on Windows 10. The other is Daggerfall Unity. I'm sure that has Windows 10 in mind. Like Windows 10 was already out when it started development. And then we've got the Song of the Ocean, which uses the PPSSPP emulator, and that's being kept up to date with regular updates and stuff. So I'm sure that will work under Windows 10. And then I have Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, which should run on just about anything. But I started by running them on Windows 7, and I'm going to keep them on Windows 7 unless, there's some other need. See you later. So I'm just going to pretend I'm this guy. I do not look like a... What's his name? Harry Dumbroski? Where does this go? Oh, back to the lobby. Only GalBank access card can unlock. So I had a few, it wouldn't be recognized. It would only be recognized by the system if I did a cold boot on it, which means just shut down the computer, wait a few seconds, and then start the computer rather than just go restart. It would only show up with that, and then I decided to start it, go into Windows 7, and then the system automatically did check disk for me and found a bunch of corrupted files and corrupted orphan files that belong to something else, but I don't know. It was like 40 files that were corrupted, approximately. And why, I have no idea. And they were all copies of my Windows 7 stuff, ironically enough. I just made a copy in case something happened to the Windows 7 disk. It has all my, my desktop and, my user documents and all that stuff just easily put in there. So I could dump it into the Windows 10 side if I need to. And some of that stuff, and it was funny, they were mods. They were mods for Skyrim, which I haven't played since 2014. So those were corrupt. And so I ran the check disk, and then I started into Windows 10. I did a scan. I defragmented the drive, and which it was hardly defragmented at all. I guess maybe check disk fixed that too. Somewhat, but seriously, defragmenting took like 30 seconds. Because even when I was able to start with it, it would crash. And it would say, critical, what does it say? System critical error? System critical, something like that. It looked bad, and it would crash. I would sit there and do nothing and it would crash. So hopefully, I'm just going to restart the recording and save. F5 is save, right? And restart the recording, because if the thing crashes now, this is not saved. This is all in progress, and it's just going to be It's just gonna be cut off, and it's not gonna be saved properly. Because when you stop the recording, it ends. It adds the header to the file, or the ending header, whatever that would be called. She's just standing there by him, and he looks at her like, okay. Alright, so I must deal with you, apparently. I heard something like open, like a door or something. Oh, that was that.
Right. Hello. Welcome to the GalBank archives. May I see your credentials, please?
You forgot what it was? Are there any other employees down here?
Oh, no. None at all. I'm all alone down here. Yeah, yep. Completely by myself. Well, I guess you're down here too, right? So, that's two of us now. Sorry, not trying to lie to you or anything. Just, yeah.
Alright. Is your first day or something? Is this where GalBank keeps all its records?
Oh, no. No, this is just their deep storage facility.
Oh, excellent.
All the current records are upstairs in the main facility. This is where they put the older data onto long-term servers.
Oh, long-term servers. That's a big term for a big boy like you. Here you go.
Just one moment while I verify. Oh, yes, Mr. Dumbroski.
Yeah?
Welcome, sir. Give me a moment to log your visit, and then I'll unseal the archives.
You're looking at me, but not really looking at me, are you? Which one do we choose? He's acting strange. You usually treat all GalBank executives this unprofessionally?
No. No. Never. Not at all. I'm so sorry. Hey, look. Please don't. Don't mention this to my supervisor, okay? She'll give me a low rating, and I'm gonna end up scrubbing floors.
Okay. Well, you're acting a bit strange.
Me?
Shrug.
No. Look, this is my first day on the job. Just cut me some slack, okay?
I knew it.
I can't afford to lose it. I got a wife and kids to feed.
I knew you were.
Everything checks out. Give me a moment to log your visit, and then I'll unseal the archives. There we go. Have a wonderful day.
Oh, that's not what I wanted. Sir. Can't get any closer than that. Mr. Dumbroski. Mm-hmm.
Don't mind me. You go do your, thing. Whatever it is.
It's stealing. My thing is stealing. What am I getting? Just getting money? What? Deal with the ecliptic ambush. That's right, you don't want to miss her off.
Bring it on! Ah! Last one over
Is that what you said? Last one?
You're a damn joke.
Yeah. You tell him. Frag grenade, okay.
Running away, eh?
Oh, don't. Wow. These guys are just hiding here waiting for us? Sturdy ecliptic pack.
See if they've got any weapons or ammo.
They do. Now I have weapons and ammo. Wait, I hear more. Where are they? Around, there's another one hiding around here somewhere. Oh, the humanity, all this stuff. Plushy galactic cat. I already have that, I think. Steel cups. Wait, what's that? Oh, espresso. You hear that? There's another one. Somewhere. I never. Cannot use these. So before I go over there and mess with that, I just want to look around. I think we're going to be assaulted once more. That just goes back down there. Where's the employee? He let us in it, then just took off. He dropped his skin cream bottle and ran for the hills. He dropped it. So that just goes around. Yeah, there's nothing. This just goes down. Goes up and all leads to this central area. Trying to throw in a quick save. I don't know if I'm hitting the wrong key for that. Here we go. Oh, a computer unfolded. I heard it. I guess there's no more ecliptics. I heard one, maybe he was still dying? I don't know. I heard him for a little while. Twice. Egmond. Alright. Indeed. Lost ship registry. GLB-044 Serendipity. Lost September 29th, 2188. Captain is D.B. Redgrave, or was. Classification transport, cargo, credits, cred tank load, really. Really? You figured they'd be all, like, there wouldn't be physical credits. I think I was holding physical credits. I mean, I don't weigh anything, but that's kind of standard. But, yeah. Weird. So there were physical credits, and that's what the transport had. Approximate value 1.76 MC? What's that? Million credits? 1.76 million credits? Transponder type CBR-27, don't know that. Departure point was Alpha Centauri Jemison. Intended arrival point is classified. Last known system position unknown. And last known planetary location unknown because of full transponder loss. Search attempts for attempts failed. See some files. Legacy? This is what we wanted? There's another cred tank load. Classified. Approximate value is classified. It's all classified. They're at Bannock system, Bannock 4. And search attempts are 8 attempts failed. Prosperity. Captain is L.M. Guthrie. So this guy, I guess this is the one we're looking for. We're looking for X Liang. So this one's a transport for GalBank supplies. Approximate value is 121.55 kilo of credits? I don't know. They departed Voli Alpha, and the arrival point is classified, and the transponder loss once again. Supremacy. Captain is CB Toussaint. Classification transport. Another cred stick load, 1.16 million credits, if that's what that means. Departure point is Mars. Arrival is Jemison. Last known planetary location is Saturn in the solar system. Alright, so that's that. Transponder information. All GalBank transports have been fitted with CBR-type encrypted transponder beacons. These beacons broadcast a predetermined long-range unique signature ping using high-frequency hyperburst scatter relays. The arrays ensure that the beacons are always broadcasting at maximum spread to assist any specially equipped search vessels. CBR transponders feature the latest in encryption technology, boasting military-grade ultra-bit encryption, fully cycling crypto-modulation, and a cascading frequency spectrum. In order to properly track a target transport, please submit a request to the security office to receive a tracking cipher. The transponders operate via an independent self-contained power source that allows them to remain detection capable for up to 250 years. Note that as the life of the power source declines, the broadcast and reception radius will be gradually reduced. Alright, I don't know if I need to know this. Encrypted transponder beacons, signature ping, high frequency. Encryption. Cryptomodulation. Cascading frequency spectrum. Okay. Database disclaimer. By accessing archive materials, you are hereby consenting to observing proprietary materials belonging to GalBank and its subsidiaries. Any information contained within this system is for the express use of GalBank employees only. Sharing this information with entities outside the GalBank ecosystem will result in immediate termination and potential criminal prosecution. I would never do anything like that, right? Any concerns regarding these rules should be directed to GalBank Legal in New Atlantis. Alright. So that's that. And then... Oops. Didn't mean to hit that. I meant to hit that. Proceed to the key. I've gained all the information I can regarding the GalBank transport legacy. I should now return to the key and report my findings to Delgado. Let me just restart the recording. I'm just being careful here. Okay. And save.
Well, I suppose they're not going to need it anymore.
No, they won't need it anymore. Not anymore. I missed that one. It surprised me. Well, his first day, I guess it's also his last, because he has abandoned his post with the door open. Maybe no one will notice. That's unlocked. Unsecured. Very good. So right, okay. I know what to do. What I'm gonna do is just run over here. Actually, we're gonna hit the tram, aren't we?
You can trust.
Spaceport. I'm not sure if I should check in with my actual real companions, so to speak. Doesn't say for me to do that. Just proceed to the key. There's a lot of steps for this quest. Damn. Stuck for a second, I couldn't move. So I do the right thing, giving her all these...
To Venus?
No.
Want to see what I'm carrying?
To the lock. Yeah, all the stolen stuff. I guess if it was on the ship, I would have been apprehended.
Goodbye.
Don't ever say goodbye. Don't ever say that.
Could not be Jemison, but this ship is starting to feel like home.
Better than Jemison. You were right there with me saying that. But you were sitting here. She's messing with my head. What's going on? That was actually our first combat in like 9 episodes because that whole heist thing was no combat. Alright, showing the map. B for B showing. So I think we can just oh, we can't fast travel this way. Can we? Can we? Is there another way? I mean, I don't mind doing it that way, but we did just travel straight here. And then we had to jump from where we were as well. Set course. So I, can I go here? Jump? Okay. Power up. My grav drive was powered up. You switched that on me. It had two bars. I saw it when we took off. Oh, that's the wrong key. Turn it on, it just automatically goes. I like that. My, my, my. Okay. So now set course. Consider this our home. I don't need Suvorov. I didn't mean to do that. Please don't kill me. I am friend. How do I? Okay.
What are you hailing for? Land in the key or don't.
Just want to say hi. Sorry for shooting you. That's because I know that's a Windows sound, and I was talking about Windows problems, but that was because I was leaning on the desk. It's the, took me actually years to figure that out. It's the USB 3. If the computer vibrates, gets bumped, moves around, it loses USB 3.
This is exactly what I pictured a haven for pirates to look like.
So as the USB 3 turns back to USB 2.0 until it comes back on, which is like instantaneous pretty much.
Next time you see Bog, shit, tell him to lighten up. You guys got a real attitude problem.
Who the hell's Bog? Speak to Bog? I have a mission now. You want me to talk to this guy?
You want to get nothing like the smell of a dead shark after you cook them with an energy blast.
Are you shooting sharks? Speak to... Is that a... That might be an activity. Speak to Bog. Let's talk to Bog first. He's here, right? These guys can wait for their GalBank crap.